Here at Tormach, we love sharing our customer stories. So here's Robert Cowan, who's making some really interesting things with his PCNC 440.
When I was a little kid, whenever I got a new toy, the very first thing I did was take it apart to see how it works. So it's kind of always been in my DNA, and it's something I've always been interested in. Even though my career kind of took a different path, it's always something that's been a hobby of mine. Realistically, I like to build just about everything. My main focus is robotics, but it really depends on what I'm feeling that week. I just like to learn new tools, new techniques. So although I have a CNC and I use it, I try not to rely on it directly for every project that I have because there's the right tool for every job. That being said, I've had the 440 for about a year now, and I've thrown just about everything at it. I've done everything from UHMW, which is a relatively hard plastic. I've done some wood on it. I've even done titanium and 4140, and I like that it's pretty consistent. Every time I put material in it, it just does exactly what I'm hoping it would do, so that's really nice. One of the things that I like about Tormach and I like about the 440 is, I guess, the ecosystem. If you've watched any of my videos, you know that I'm using the passive probe on every single project. I really like how seamlessly the passive probe integrates in the path pilot and makes it really easy to indicate off a part. It might not be the old school way of doing it, it might not be the most accurate way of doing it. For a hobbyist like me, it makes it really easy and really accessible to just put in a piece, indicate off of it, and just go. I think you guys did a really damn good job with PathPilot, honestly. Like, I get that that was probably a really hard decision to break off and create your own custom that you now have to support. Once it's done, it makes a lot of sense. So a long time ago, I started out in audio and I wanted to build an amplifier and I realized all I had was a drill and a couple screwdrivers. And I looked online and I found this thing called a CNC machine and I thought it was the coolest thing ever. Actually, I ended up buying a manual mill, bringing it home, adding all the electronics. I had wood pieces that were running all the mechanical stuff. It was a piece of junk. And then finally, I just got fed up with it and got the Tormach, which was night and day difference. And it was nice not to have a machine that every time I go out to use it, I had to fiddle with it or fix something or change something. So it's really nice having a machine that I didn't make and I didn't build that just works when I needed to. So right now I'm kind of on a robotics kick and I'm really into combat robots. It's a really difficult challenge to build a robot that can go into arena with another robot that's trying to kill you and make sure you last that whole 3 minutes. So it's a really big challenge. There's a lot of material science, there's a lot of electronics knowledge, and it's just really complicated to do. So I don't find myself getting bored with that anytime soon. So I'm focused on that. With the increasing popularity of 3D printing, a lot of people think that CNC and machining is just as simple. You just take a block of material, put it in the machine, download your file, hit a button, and you're just good to go. But I've been machining on and off for the last, let's say, 10 years, and it is a lot more complicated than that. There's a lot more to know. There's all the fixturing and the work coordinate systems and all the different tools that you need. And the good thing about machining and CNC in general is there's a lot to learn. You can never really get bored with it. If you're a machinist doing the same part over and over and over, it might get a little bit stale, but every new project that you approach, there's always something new to learn. And there's a lot of great videos on YouTube and there's a lot of great stuff out there that you can learn all this new stuff really easily, and then you can make the stuff that you want to make. From my audience and the people that care about me or trust me, they probably want to know ease of use, because I do cater to a lot more beginners, not the crusty old machinists. They probably don't like me, which is fine. My main goal for my channel is, I'm already doing this stuff on my own. This is something that I would be doing with or without the camera sitting there. So what I'm trying to accomplish is get other people excited and get people motivated into doing these same projects. So if I build a combat robot, or if I convert a 3D printer over into new electronics, or if I start using a laser cutter for new and different purposes, I want to show people how they can do that same thing so that if they have this tool, or if they have this idea even, it gives them the ability to also do that, because YouTube is a great resource for learning things, and that's how I learned, and that's how a lot of us do learn, is we just watch other people doing it. So I could just sit here in my shop and do everything without any cameras and just do it on my own, but I really like to share and show people the process so that other people can do this as well.
Thanks for watching. Check out all of our latest videos here, and for more metalworking tips, tricks, and stories, subscribe to the YouTube channel.